Channel. I'm Sulakshana Vagmare and today we will learn the chapter Motion and Types of Motions. Now, we have to consider the different types of motion that we see in our daily life. So, for your reference, here I have mentioned some examples. Let us see those examples. Firstly, motion of car. We always used to see many vehicles moving on a road. So, out of that, I have taken the motion of the car. Now you can see car, it means most probably car used to travel in a straight line along a straight path. Secondly, motion of tap of water, means tap water. You can see when we just turn the tap, water start flowing through the tap. So you can see that motion is also in a straight line. Then motion of fan. You can see the fan used to rotate around a single point. So that kind of motion is circular motion here. Then motion of groups of ants, means you must have seen ants used to travel one behind another, means in a straight line. And you can see they never used to change their path, and even the speed with which each ant is traveling is constant speed. Means they never used to change their speed also. Then motion of swing, you must have played the swing. Then movements of birds of wings. Then motion of clock hands, motion of butterfly. Now you can see in all these examples we have different types of motions. So that types we are going to study here. Now let us start with simple motion, like motion of car. So it is straight line motion, it is known as linear motion. This is the first type that we will study here. So let us start. Now here, first motion we are talking about is linear motion. The motion in a straight line or along a straight path is linear motion. So I will mention here, it is motion along a straight line. Means the traveling car, if the traveling car is turning right or turning left, that motion will not be linear motion. So you can take some other examples also. For example, motion of bullock cart, then also the motion of ball which is moving on the ground, then our walking style. These all are the examples of motion in straight line. So this motion is known as linear motion. Now suppose, means here also, for the linear motion, there are two types of linear motion. First linear motion, means I will take one example. If we are walking on a ground or if we are walking on a road, we used to walk in a straight line. But what happens? Our speed may increase or decrease. Means we can walk fast, we can run also. Means we are traveling in a straight line, but speed is not constant. So this is the first case. For the second case, let us take one example. Suppose you are standing at point A, then you start walking. After 5 minutes, you come at point B. Its timing is, I will write T as time, 5 minutes. And suppose the distance you covered from A to B, that is D, is suppose 5 meter or 5 kilometer, we can say. Means in 5 minutes you are covering a distance of 5 kilometer. So what next? Now suppose from point B you are moving towards north point, you are coming at point C. Again for same time you are covering the same distance. That means for specific time you are covering the particular distance. So this kind of motion, the motion in which the distance covered by the object for a particular time is same, it is known as uniform linear motion. I will give you more examples. Firstly, I have mentioned the example of ants, means they are covering specific distance in a particular time. So that kind of motion is also uniform motion. And try to remember the motion of soldiers who are performing the parade. Means you can see their walking style. All means there are many soldiers, but all are covering similar distance at similar time. Means their footsteps are very perfect and we can see their neatness and cleanness of footsteps. So this kind of motion is also uniform motion. So here we have two kinds of linear motion. Firstly, non-uniform linear motion like our walking, and secondly, the uniform linear motion. So I will write it here. Means for linear motion, we have two kinds of motion. Non-uniform and uniform. Now try to recollect some more examples for non-uniform and uniform linear motion. For non-uniform linear motion, you will get many examples. But for uniform linear motion, you have to think. Two examples I have mentioned already. Our car or train also sometimes move with uniform motion. For example, suppose one train is moving from, let us say, from Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus to Panvel. Suppose after starting with zero speed, means initially it is starting with zero speed. After 5 minutes, you will see that the train will attain the uniform speed. Uniform speed means suppose it will move with the speed of 40 or 50. With 50 speed, it will cover the same distances for the same time. Means for every 5 minutes, it will cover almost 5 kilometer distance. So this kind of motion is also uniform motion. So for the linear motion, we have uniform linear motion and non-uniform linear motion. Now let us move towards our next type. Consider the motion of the fan. You can see the fan is rotating in a circular manner. Also remember the motion of marigold. You must have played on that. These kinds of motion are also the means motion of hands of a clock. This is also circular motion. Means the things which are rotating around a fixed point in a circular manner, these kinds of motion are known as circular motion. Here we can take many examples. For example, motion of earth around the sun, then motion of moon around the earth. These all are the examples of circular motion. Now let us write it. Second type of motion we have, circular motion. So here I will write, a motion of a particle around a fixed point in a circular manner is called circular motion. So this is the example, and the best example nowadays you can also take. While playing the garba, most of the places they make circle, and within the circle they used to play the garba. So this is also the example of circular motion there. So second type of motion we have, it is circular motion. Now let us move toward our next type. Motion. I will explain you. Actually, periodic motion can be circular motion or linear motion, but the thing is that when suppose any particle is in motion, it used to repeat the motion at regular interval of time. I will explain you how. Suppose this is the ceiling of your house. Tie one thread and at the bottom you will tie one rubber ball. So let use some movement to ball, means you will just hold the ball and use some movement. So what will happen? The ball will start moving between these two points. I will explain you how. See, ball will come here first and will go here then. Then again it will come back, go here, come back. Means you can see the ball is performing motion around its middle position. The position A, means from A it is going to B, coming back to A, again going to C. Means the ball is performing repeated motion around the point A. Now this point A is known as mean position. Mean position means original position of the ball. So you can see it is performing the repeated motion, means coming and going and coming, coming and going. So like this, this kind of motion is known as the periodic motion, means after the regular interval of time, it is performing the periodic motion. Now, actually, this example is also true for oscillatory motion that we will study later on. I will explain you that. Now, take another example of periodic motion. Suppose, look at the motion of the clock hand. Suppose we will take minute hand. We will see that your minute hand is covering exactly equal distance for 1 hour. Means suppose this is the clock you have, these are the numbers on the clock: 12, 3, 6, and 9. You will observe that suppose this minute hand we are taking, suppose we are starting from 12, so after 1 minute, by completing the one rotation, it will come to this position only. look, means you can observe this for several times, means for equal interval of time, for equal regular intervals of time, your minute hand is performing the same, means similar motion. So this kind of motion is also a periodic motion. Means periodic motion can be linear motion or circular motion or vibratory motion, but the condition is that after some time the motion must be repeated. For example, the motion of the moon around the earth, then the motion of earth towards itself, means around itself, means earth used to complete one rotation around itself by 24 hours, means after 24 hours the position of a particular point of the world will be similar. So because of that only we used to see the day and nights. Then again the motion of the earth around the sun to complete one circle, it takes 365 days. So these all are the examples of periodic motion, means after the certain time the motion is repeated for some means for particular time. So this kind of motion is known as periodic motion here. So I will explain you the next type. See, I'm explaining you different examples, and also there are some example which are going for different means similar example is going for different motions. But don't get confused. I will clarify everything here. Fourth type motion we have oscillatory motion. Oscillatory motion. Now again I will give you this setup is known as pendulum. You can see our ball was going to point C, coming back to A, going to B, then coming back to A. Now this motion we can call it as periodic motion if and only if, suppose the time taken by the ball from going to A to C is, suppose, means from here to here, it is taking suppose 3 minutes, and again from going from A to B it is taking 3 minutes, then we can say this is the periodic motion, means after 3 minutes our motion is repeated. But if the time is decreases, means actually in practical life, if you are moving the ball and you will release, after some time you will observe that ball will stop, means its length will goes on decreasing, means firstly it will go to C, then for the next it will come to this point, then this point, here also same thing, means its amplitude, means length will get decreased, and lastly your ball will stop moving. So this kind of motion, if the ball is not covering same distances for same time, that means your ball just moving. So this kind of motion where time is not constant and distance covered is not constant, this kind of motion is known as oscillatory motion. Oscillatory motion means one particle is crossing through a point but time may not be same. For example, here for the oscillatory motion we can take one example, the needle of sewing machine. You must have seen the needle used to move like this. So that motion is also oscillatory motion. Then again, remember the motion of wings of birds, means firstly it spread the wings, then take it close to the body, then spread, then close. So this kind of motion is also oscillatory motion. Then again, when electricity is not there, then we used to take the air by that hand fan. So that motion of hand fan is also oscillatory motion. So these are the motions which are known as oscillatory motion. So let us write when a particle in motion.
Lot of students waste their precious time watching cartoons, movies, reality shows on TV. Then they waste their time on social networking sites. When the students sit to study, they are unable to concentrate to get your studies finished and they get low marks in exams. Parents shell out tons of money from their pockets for coaching classes. But who knows what is taught in these classes? Teachers at times get bugged up when you ask them questions. YouTube has a lot of information but little of use. This is where Study Spectrum TV channel comes in picture. Every chapter explained by different teachers with different examples and repeat telecasts. We remember 20% of the audio ads we hear, 30% of the printed items we see. But we remember 70% of the audio visuals. That is why video teaching is a powerful medium to learn. After watching Study Spectrum TV channel, you get a peaceful sleep with no tensions and no worries. You devote less time towards your studies and you get better marks in your exams. Visit us on www.studyspectrum.com. Follow us on Facebook. So what are you waiting for? Subscribe for Study Spectrum TV channel and keep edifying.
What is random motion? If you remember, I have given you an example of motion of butterfly. Now you can see butterfly used to move randomly. There is no particular pattern or nothing is there that we can say this is the common thing in the motion of the butterfly. Here it used to wander here and there. So this kind of motion is random motion. You can take many examples of random motion, just like motions of insects, then also the motions of different things that we can see. If we are considering a car, then car may take right turn, left turn, or it may go straight. In this case, the motion of the car will be random motion. Then again, if we are playing with ball, means it may be cricket ball or it may be football, again that motion will be random motion. Means there is no particular pattern of time, there is no particular pattern of distance. We can't predict that the ball will cover this distance for this particular time. So these kinds of motion are random motions. So here in this way, we have total 5 kinds of motion: linear motion, circular motion, then periodic motion, oscillatory motion, and random motion. So these are the different types of motion. Now let us summarize these motions and write down their definitions. Now let us summarize all kinds of motion. Here I have written these motions for your reference. First motion, linear motion. Again we have two types of linear motions: uniform linear motion and non-uniform linear motion. Then circular motion, periodic motion, oscillatory motion and random motion. Now let us summarize. Linear motion is a motion along a straight line, whereas we have two kinds of linear motions. Uniform linear motion is first type. Uniform linear motion is a motion in which specific distance is covered in a particular period. If you remember, I had given you example of moving from A to B and from B to C, that straight line motion. Then here we can take another examples: soldiers marching in a parade and the motion of ants. Means they are walking in a straight line. Second following the first, then third following the second, like that. So that kind of motion is also uniform. Now let us revise all kinds of motion. Here for your reference, I have drawn all type of motion here. So first we have studied linear motion, then circular motion, periodic motion, oscillatory motion and random motion. So totally we have 5 types of motion here. So let us recollect one by one. So first motion is linear motion. It is the motion along a straight line. Again, in linear motion, we have two types: uniform linear motion and non-uniform linear motion. Let us see uniform linear motion. It is a motion in which specific distance is covered in a particular period. So here we can take examples of soldiers marching in a parade and also motion of ants. So these two are examples of uniform linear motion. Means in this type of motion, particular distance, means specific distance is covered in specific time. If you remember, I had given you an example. Means if you are moving from point A to B, you will cover distance of 5 km in 5 minutes. And again, if you are moving towards north from point B to C, again you will cover 5 km distance for 5 minutes. So, for equal interval of time, equal distance is covered. But the condition is, the motion will be along the straight line. So, that's why it is uniform circular motion. Non-uniform circular means non-uniform motion. That is, non-uniform linear motion is... So it is uniform linear motion. Now again, for non-uniform linear motion, the motion is along the straight line, but this condition is not satisfied. That means for equal interval of time, you will cover the equal distance. This condition is not satisfied. That's why it is non-uniform linear motion. Now we will take one examples here. Motion of man walking on a road. Or we can take example of ourselves also. We are walking on the road in a straight line. Then girl who is on slide. You can see when girl sliding, the speed increases continuously while coming down. So this is the motion which is in the straight line. But speed keeps on increasing. That's why it is non-uniform linear motion. So these are the examples of non-uniform linear motion. Now let us move towards circular motion. Again, this is a motion which is taking place along the circular path, or the motion around the circumference of a circle is circular motion. Here we can take examples of motion of fan. Then again, the example of rotation of earth around the sun. Then motion of earth we can write. So these all are the examples of circular motion. Then again motion of marigold and all. So these are the examples of circular motion. Next motion we have studied, it is periodic motion. Now remember, periodic motion may be circular motion or periodic motion may be linear motion. But here the condition is, when a moving object passes through a certain point at regular intervals of time, its motion is periodic motion. Means after a regular interval of time, the particle will cover the same distance. Here we will take examples of motion of minute hand in a clock. You can take minute hand or hour hand. Then again, the motion of earth around the sun, motion of moon around the earth, because after particular time, this motion is repeated. Means definitely for 24 hours earth will cover up, means earth will rotate around itself. It will complete one rotation. Similarly, for covering one rotation, the earth will take 365 days around the sun. Again, these kinds of motion, means for example, I have explained you the example of pendulum. Means pendulum is vibrating, it is moving. The means this kind of motion is actually back and forth motion, means coming back, going forth, coming back, going forth. Means this is actually oscillatory motion, but, and you can see this is just covering the arc. Or suppose your thread is long enough, then we will just imagine it is a straight line motion. But thing is that it is a back and forth motion. But here, if this condition is satisfied, means if for equal interval of time, if equal distance is covered, then this will be the periodic motion. Means after a certain period, your motion is repeated. So this kind of motion is also periodic motion. So periodic motion may be circular motion or linear motion or vibratory motion. Then again we have next type, oscillatory motion. So the definition is a back and forth repetitive motion. Motion, it is a back and forth repetitive motion of an object. Means back and forth means, for example, the pendulum example means it is going to left, again coming to its main position, then going right, again coming to its main position. So back, forth, back, forth. So this kind of motion is oscillatory motion. Again, we can take example of the motion of needle of the sewing machine, and also the motion of the wings of the birds. So let us write those examples. Pendulum, then sewing machine, sorry, needle of the sewing machine, then motion of wings of bird. Also, when we have a call, our mobile also used to vibrate. That kind of motion is also oscillatory motion. Then lastly, we have studied the random motion. In this, I have explained you the example of the motion of the butterfly. So butterfly moves randomly here and there. Means in this case, direction also changes continuously. Even the speed also changes continuously. So that kind of motion is random motion. So it is motion of butterfly. Now lastly, we have one topic that is very simple topic. We have to find out speed of the object. Now it is very simple thing. Means suppose I'm walking on a road, I'm covering 1 kilometer distance for half an hour. Then how to calculate speed? Actually, speed is distance covered by the object for a particular time. Or we can say distance covered of an object for unit time. Unit time means you can consider 1 hour, 1 minute or 1 second. Unit means what? So let us write down the formula of speed. Speed is distance upon time. So speed is denoted by small v, distance is denoted by s, and time is denoted by small t. So this is the notation for speed. V is equal to s upon t. That is, speed of the object is equal to distance covered by the object upon time taken covering, means time taken for covering that particular distance. So this is your formula, and obviously we will calculate unit also. Unit means, for example, we measure length in kilometers or centimeters, we measure time in seconds or hours. So if we are taking distance in kilometer and time in second, then 1 unit will be kilometer per second. So this will be the MKS unit. MKS system means there are two systems of units, MKS system and CGS system. In MKS system, we usually take the greater unit, means length will be measured in kilometer, mass will be measured in kilogram, then also different things, means time even we can measure in the seconds only. Time we can't measure in the hours and all. Time is also always taken as in the form of seconds. And CGS unit, we take the smaller units, means mass is taken in grams, then length is taken in centimeters. Here, for the CGS system, the unit will be meter per second. So we have two units, kilometer per second in MKS system, and in CGS system, meter per second. So here we complete our chapter. We have studied 5 types of motion, and lastly, how to calculate speed of the object. Now we will solve exercise of this chapter. Now let us calculate the units of the speed. Just like length is measured in kilometers or meters or centimeters, then time is measured in seconds, mass is measured in kilograms or grams. So in that way, we will calculate the unit of the speed here. But before that, remember, we have two measuring systems, MKS system and CGS system. Now MKS means here, MKS. MKS system means what? Firstly, we will measure the distance in the form of meters. Secondly, we will measure the mass of the object in the form of kilogram, and time is measured in the form of seconds. So here, meter, kilogram, second. So that stands for MKS system. And secondly, we have CGS system. Here again, the distance is measured in terms of centimeters instead of meters. Means here it is measured in meter, and in the second system it is measured in centimeters. So that's why C. Then CGS means, definitely, firstly we had measured the mass of the object in the form of kilogram. Here we will measure in the form of grams. So G stands for gram. And again, the time, the unit of the time will remain same. Time we will always take in the form of seconds. So S stands for seconds. So these two systems we have. So you can see the formula of speed is distance upon time. Now distance we will measure in the form of meters. So according to MKS system, unit will be meter per second, because we are taking time in the form of second. And for the CGS system, we will take distance in the form of centimeters. So unit will become centimeter per second. So meter per second is MKS system, and centimeter per second is CGS system. Means most probably, while calculating the different things, means while measuring the length or taking the mass, we most probably we use MKS system. So it is nowadays we have one system. It is
lot of students waste their precious time watching cartoons, movies, reality shows on TV. Then they waste their time on social networking sites. When the students sit to study, they are unable to concentrate to get your studies finished and they get low marks in exams. Parents shell out tons of money from their pockets for coaching classes. But who knows what is taught in these classes? Teachers at times get bugged up when you ask them questions. YouTube has a lot of information but little of use. This is where Study Spectrum TV channel comes in picture. Every chapter explained by different teachers with different examples and repeat telecasts. We remember 20% of the audio ads we hear, 30% of the printed items we see. But we remember 70% of the audio visuals. That is why video teaching is a powerful medium to learn. After watching Study Spectrum TV channel, you get a peaceful sleep with no tensions and no worries. You devote less time towards your studies and you get better marks in your exams. Visit us on www.studyspectrum.com. Follow us on Facebook. So what are you waiting for? Subscribe for Study Spectrum TV channel and keep edifying.
Nowadays we are using this SI system, means it is based on MK system only, but the SI system is actually International System of Units. This we are using means we will consider the MKS units only, but this is standardized, means it is international system. It is made because see different countries have different systems of units, so there is confusion. So that's why to remove those criterias we are using SI system today. So by using this system also the unit of velocity will meter per second. So you will find that by calculating velocity or measuring distances, measuring masses, SI system is used nowadays. So at this particular point we complete our chapter. So we will solve the exercise next time.